Years back, if you wanted to mask out a moving subject, you'd have to do it manually, going frame by frame like some kind of After Effects caveman. It was a different time. A hard time. We don't talk about that. However, in the last couple of years, Adobe has integrated tools inside of Premiere Pro and After Effects to track masks so you can spend less time rotoscoping and more time creating. So today, we're going to look at a couple of ways to track your mask. With our clip selected inside of Premiere, we're going to go to Opacity, Effects Control, and tap this pen tool. Now inside of our program monitor, we're going to mask our subject, then back in Effects Controls, we're going to tap this Track Forward button. If your mask has trouble tracking, then you can also track frame by frame and make adjustments in any needed areas. And as simple as that, you have your mask tracked. And now we can add any effect that we want, like blurring out a face or object or for color. There's two methods to track a mask inside of After Effects. One of them we showed in a previous episode where we learn how to use the roto brush tool. So check that out if you haven't. And if you haven't, what's wrong with you? Are we fighting? But there is that second way. So go up to the toolbar and select the pen tool. You can also use your shortcut and press G on your keyboard to select the pen tool if you're fancy. Now mask around your subject. And with that done, find your tracker window. If you don't see it, yell tracker window really loud like you're in Mickey Mouse's clubhouse and it'll magically appear. If that doesn't work, go to window, then tap tracker. You can also right click the mask and hit track mask. Here you should see your mask selected. If you don't, click the dropdown on your clip and select the mask you want to track. You'll have multiple methods to choose from, but for this example, we'll stick with position, scale, and rotation. Now click the track forward button and After Effects will do its thing. And if you want to apply these keyframes to another layer like a solid, all you have to do is tap your mask and use the shortcut Control-C on Windows or Command-C on Mac to copy, then paste using the shortcut Command-V or Control-V if you're on Windows. I probably didn't need to tell you how to copy and paste, but we're all about education here, wherever here is. I actually don't know, I'm here against my will. Another great feature that After Effects offers is their face tracker. So create a mask around your subject's face, then right click and track mask. Change the method to face tracking, detailed features. Now, when you mask forward, After Effects will not only do a great job at tracking your face, but it will set tracking points for your eyes, nose, mouth, cheeks, and chin, giving you a lot of options to play with. If you use a regular face tracker, you can copy and paste the mask to an adjustment layer and do some color correction on the face. Or you can add a bulge effect, increasing the size of your subject's eyes, and then pick whip that to your left and right eye pupil. And now you have a bulge eye effect tracked to the eyes. Or you can also create demon eyes by creating a darker colored solid using a pen tool to mask around the eyes, and then opening the transform dropdown and grab the position pick whip and connect that to its respective pupil track. If your mask slips during the shot, then just adjust your anchor point on the solid, and now you have some creepy eyes.
Wow.
We've used this technique a ton on my show Film Riot, making Snapchat style filters in a scene, throwing masks or hats over a talent, and so on. And I bring this up purely for shameless self-promotion. But that's how you can use the mask tracker inside of Premiere and After Effects, which honestly have endless creative possibilities and plenty of very simple and quick fix functions. But that's it for today. As always, if there's something you'd like to see us cover on the show in the future, shoot us a comment below. And subscribe to the channel for more tutorials and updates like this one, because clicking is a workout for your finger, and I'm just putting your health first.